Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. If you're one of my subscribers, you have probably seen one of my videos about how to make passive income with Etsy. What that means is you can create and sell digital products that you can sell on Etsy from anywhere in the world. I have sold over 4,000 digital products since I started my shop a few years ago. And in today's video, I want to show you how we can use ChatGPT to help us create and sell printables on Etsy. So before we get started, I have linked you to my full Etsy shop tutorial series if you want to learn how to open up an Etsy shop step by step. So the first thing I want to do is open up Etsy.com, and I just typed in fun printables. And you can see here, there are thousands of different printables that people are selling on Etsy. So I just typed in fun printables, and you can see there are over 100,000 results. So of course, we want to narrow it down a bit. Now, at Christmas time, I decided to do a test, and I created about 10 different Christmas printables that were like games for kids and activities, and I made a couple hundred dollars selling these printables during the Christmas season. So right now, the next holiday that is upon us is Easter, and that's coming up quick. So let's type in Easter printables for kids. And even as you're typing it in, you can see different keywords are popping up. Easter printables, crafts, kids, adults, religious, first grades. So when people are searching for these, they might have something very particular that they're looking for, and that is the niche that you can target. So I'm going to put in Easter printables for kids games. And you can see here, these ones at the top are ones that have paid for ads. But if you scroll down, here are a bunch of different activities. And you can see that the most popular ones are bundles. So if we look at this one here, this is a bestseller. And this one is super simple. It's an outdoor Easter treasure hunt. And these printables are extremely easy to create. And I'm going to show you an example of something that we can do. So if we look here, this person has an Easter Mad Libs activity. And it's very basic, but very beautiful. So if you don't know what Mad Libs is, it's basically a story and you take out a few words. So for example, in this activity, the teacher would ask the students on a piece of paper to write down one emotion, a number, a verb, an adjective, and later you read out this really funny, crazy story that you've created. Mad Libs are very popular in schools as an activity for teachers. So she's selling just one page, just one printable for €2.50. And this is something we can create very easily with ChatGPT and Canva. Now, this woman has a very beautiful custom image. So you can see not only has she just put on the Mad Libs, she's decorated it for Easter. It looks very professional. And I have a tutorial about how to create a custom listing that I have linked you to in the description below as well, if you check out my Etsy playlist. Okay, so we're going to go over to ChatGPT. So I want to show you how we can create a printable like this. But before we get started, we can use ChatGPT for some ideas. I can say, what are the most popular printables that are sold on Etsy? Now, ChatGPT only has knowledge up to, I think, 2021 at this current time, but they are giving a bunch of ideas that are still relevant today. So you can see here, planner pages, calendars, wall art, wedding invitations and stationery, party decorations, coloring pages. Okay, and you can ask ChatGPT to give you even more ideas. Okay, now we're going to get ChatGPT to help us create this Mad Libs idea. First of all, I'm going to say, create a funny Easter story about two children hunting for the Easter bunny who stole their pet bunny. Okay, I gave ChatGPT an actual story idea, but you could literally just say, create a funny Easter story about two children or whatever. And ChatGPT right now is going to create this story for us. So ChatGPT has written the Easter story, but I wanted it to be a little shorter so it will fit on the page. So I said, condense the story into 4 paragraphs and replace Jack and Jill with Tommy and Molly. So now it's created our story. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to open up a new chat for this just because my ChatGPT stopped working. But I'm going to say, create a Mad Libs activity with this story, and I'm going to paste the story. Then I'm going to say, take out 15 different words. And you can see that ChatGPT has just put in a spot for the adjective, for the verb, for the adjective, verb. So this is the full story, the original story. And this is the one with the Mad Libs activity. And actually, when you sell something like this, I think it's a great idea to include both the original story and also the Mad Libs story. So now what we're going to do is take our story, copy it. We're going to go to Canva, and Canva is totally free. You can sign up clicking on the link in the description below using my referral link. And we're going to click create a design, and we're going to go custom size. And then here, change it to inches and put in 8.5 by 11 inches. And this is the standard paper size in North America. And then click create new design. So from here, you can go ahead and make it completely customize it by adding your own background color or whatever. But an easier way to do it is to go here to templates, type in Easter, enter. And they're going to find us a bunch of templates that are Easter related that we can use that are this size. So let's scroll down, find one that we like. Let's say this one here. So now it's just filled it in so it's the size. And we're going to slide on this up here to zoom up, and we can erase any information we don't need. So I'm going to erase all the text. We don't need that. And this little graphic I don't want. And we can make the title. So we can put, let's put the Easter Bunny Mad Libs. And you can just adjust it like that. We can adjust the size. So you can see how this person has it with their border, Easter Mad Libs, and then their story. So now what we'll do, I'm going to zoom out, and we can move these bunnies if we want, move them up here. We can erase them if we want. I'm going to make this a bit bigger so we can put our story here. And we're going to go over to text, click on add a heading or add a text box. And I'm going to paste in the story. First, I'm going to change the font to around maybe 14 and control V to paste the story. So here we have our full story, but we want to make it look nicer than that, and I'll show you how to do it. So first I'm going to erase some of these background images so we have a bit more space. Okay, so now what we want to do is click here on spacing, and so we want to increase the space a bit, and we might want to reduce the size as well. And now what we want to do is replace all of these that say adjective, verb, with lines underneath so the kids could write that. So we go like this, for example, and then what we'll want to do is click on text and click on this little bit of body of text there, and we're going to put in adjective. And what we'll do is we'll make this really small, maybe 8 or 9. You could even change the color to purple or something so it stands out. And this would just indicate that when the kids are playing this activity or whoever, they'd have to put an adjective here. So now we'll just go ahead and continue that for all of these. So what we can do is zoom up and let's click on adjective, control C to copy, control V to paste. And then now we can just change that by double clicking and putting verb. Okay, so once you've done that, you can go over here to elements and you can type in Easter. Let's say you wanted to take out the bunnies and add something else or add different bunnies. You've got all sorts of different options here. And another thing you can do is go here, click duplicate, and that will give you a second page. So this page, for example, could be your activity page, and the second page could be the original story. So you could just remove all of this and add in the original story that you got from ChatGPT. So that way the teacher could read that to the kids afterwards, for example. And when you're finished, to download our worksheet or our printable, we'll click share, download, and we're going to download it as a PDF standard. And you can say include one page or all the pages, and then click flatten PDF, and that will make sure it prints properly. Then click download. And here you go. Here we have our printable, which I think looks awesome. So from here, you would go ahead, create a digital listing on Etsy. So like this girl here, this is her digital listing, Easter Mad Libs, Printable Easter Game, Easter Activity. You can see lots of different keywords. Here's her description. And what you can do is you can actually just go into ChatGPT. We can actually say, write a listing for a digital product on Etsy selling this fun Easter Bunny Mad Libs activity for students. The product includes 2 worksheets, 1 PDF file. Oh, this is so great. Honestly, it's creating the entire ad for you. It even says, this is a digital product only, no physical item will be shipped. It's telling you that it's an instant digital download. I mean, this is so awesome. So you could copy and paste this, change it up, and add that to Etsy as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and got a little bit inspired about the kinds of printables that you can get started creating with Canva and using ChatGPT. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one and click like if you enjoyed this video. I'll see you in my next tutorial.